Hey, welcome back to Winchester Fail. It's Cassia. Today, we are working with flowers. Well, sort of. We're using fake flowers today, which I already stripped off of a flower bundle mass, so then I don't have to waste time with that. And what I'm going to do with these today is, hopefully, coat them in plaster of Paris. And then I'm going to take that and stick them to a picture frame, and it's supposed to look really cute. I have a little example I found on Pinterest. Looks like this. Wow. So it's kind of elegant, and I'm hoping that's what I'm going to accomplish today. The way that you mix plaster of Paris, I had to run around town to find this plaster of Paris, and the only size it came in was this big. 5 pounds. I'm not going to use this much plaster of Paris. I'm only going to try this once because the flowers I'm using are really just leftovers from a different Winchester fail. The plaster of Paris, you mix it in water at a 1-to-1 ratio according to the bag. So I'm going to do that. I've got my water already measured out. I'm using just half a cup because I really don't have that much to dip my flower pieces into. Stir until smooth. This suggests a pour into molds, but that's not what I'm doing today. This looks like gross paper mache stuff. The texture of paper mache makes me feel nasty, so I'm hoping I should wear gloves. Oh well, here we go, getting dirty. So I'm going to take my couple of tiny flower bundle bits, dip it in so it gets nice. Actually, I might just drop it. I'm going to drop it in with my spoon, fish it back out. And then let it dry, I think. Yes? Pretty sure. I didn't watch a tutorial, but I actually did see some of the photo log. It's not really coating them. Maybe if I do a second dip. Or, actually, really, what this is doing is hardening the flower pieces and working on creating a uniform color. So once they dry, I can actually just paint them. Oh no. I lost it. Okay, run. Maybe I should leave them in longer. I don't know if that's helpful or not. Trial and error. Now I think what they had done on theirs was they did the plaster of Paris flowers and the leaves, and then they stuck them on, potentially with plaster of Paris, or maybe just like glue or hot glue or whatever, and then they spray painted over it white uniform, so then any pieces that you might miss on your flowers with the plaster of Paris, like if it's not soaking it in or soaking it up or anything like that, you'll get it with your paint. So, I don't have any white spray paint. I might just go through and use regular white acrylic paint. See how it works. I could try to paint with the plaster of Paris, but I don't know if that's going to give me the kind of chalky look I'm imagining would happen, you know, the chalk paints. So, I think I'll let these sit for a little bit to make sure they dry and they stiffen up. I'll check back in. Okay, so we're back. These are mostly all completely dry. I did come back in and double dip 3 of them just to see what it would look like, and that was when it was starting to thicken up. Now it's like completely hardened. So they feel like chips. They're really thick now. The ones that I double coated don't look great, so I think I'll just try to stick them on and kind of layer them accordingly. All of the leaves that I made look pretty good. They're pretty solid. Still slightly bendable, but that's because it has the thin coat. So I believe I'm gonna just start Mod Podging and sticking these on. I'm gonna be pretty haphazard with my gluing because I'm just gonna like spray over this anyways with the color of choice. And I actually found out that my white acrylic paint is kind of running out. So I found this lovely gold metallic spray paint. So I'm gonna try that. It's pretty old, but I'm gonna see how it works. Now the only issue is figuring out how to stick this on. Okay. Because they're weird angles now and weird shapes, it's gonna require some extra finagling. So far it just looks like a weird mess. So I'm almost done layering on all of the floral pieces, but this has been kind of a fiasco. I am glad in the long run that out of all of the glue options I had the thicker Mod Podge because these are so tough to adhere because they don't mold, they don't flex anymore, they just sit. I don't know, we'll see. I'm gonna let it dry completely before I continue and then spray it. So this is the mess it kinda looks like right now for my picture frame. We will see. Okay, so that took so long to dry and then to spray, and then I had to spray paint again to do touch-ups, and it just taking me all day basically to finish this. So this is the final result. Here's a closer look at the final result. So it's interesting. Textured, definitely. It reminds me of like the people that dress in all one metallic color and then are street performers. Now I went with the bronze. You could do white. Obviously you can do whatever color you want, but since not everything was glued down and completely dry, I do still have some flexible pieces. So I just want to be careful when I hang it up or put something in it, not to bump them. And just kinda take all of it off because I actually don't know how well secured everything is. Looks something like this with a real picture in, actually a fake picture in, but you can see that it's interesting. I think it kind of did not exceed my expectations. It just looks sort of gloppy and messy in the end. And maybe if I was finer with my details, and I don't know. It's a cool idea and an interesting technique. I think it's a little tough to really understand how the plaster of Paris is gonna work when you set everything. I think the flowers were especially difficult to manipulate. So, kinda rate this a good concept, not great execution. Could have been worse, that's for sure, but not my favorite. So, go ahead and give it a try for yourself. I think maybe if I had done it with just white, it would have looked really cool, very Victorian or something like that. So, depending on what kind of house you live in or your decor, it could really blend into anything that you're doing, as long 'cause it's one like chromatic texture piece. And then you can have whatever you want as your photo inside. I just don't have photos, so that's it for today. So thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you try it for yourself and leave me some suggestions for things that I can try in the future. And I look forward to seeing you later. Bye!